I was just thinking when you were throwing all those fours out, I loathe to say it, but wouldn't the Canucks love to have 4-4 with them here tonight? Here's Yellen in Vancouver's home with a wrist shot. That deflected off Marek Milik and over top of the goal. Shabarov trying to move the puck out. Can't do it. Jovanovski now gives it away. Here's a shot by Yell. All the save as he came out to challenge. And he hangs on for the whistle as Stefan Yell leaned into that turnover off the stick of Ed Jovanovski.
Well, I think it's clearly obvious that you brought up number 44, Todd Bertuzzi. There's no question that the Canucks would be a much different team in this series against Calgary with Big 44 in their lineup. And he is sorely missed, that's for sure.
I think we made it to game six before we brought it up. 8:22 to go in double overtime. Face off to the right of Alex Hall. And the fans getting on the Vancouver goaltender again as the Canucks control off the draw in their own zone and get the puck out to center. Daniel Sedin picks it off there and now dumps it deep into the Calgary zone. Kiprasov out of his net, leaves behind the goal for Robin Regier. Regier carries to center. Nice move, now a nice pass onto the right wing for Jelena. He finds Conroy speeding down that right side, but his shot attempt went off the end of his stick and wide of the goal. Fight for the puck on the near side. Aginla's had his helmet ripped off again. Puck comes back to the line, Regier with a long shot, and that was blocked by Matthias Olin. Jelena on the right wing, turns into the corner, leaves the puck there for Aginla. He's checked. Canucks trying to get the puck to center. They do. Here comes Linden. Linden by himself. His line mate's changing. Moves in on the right wing. Now stops, waiting for some help. Centers. Naslund dishes off for Morse, and the pass was knocked away. Naslund had a clear path to the goal and elected to pass. Conroy comes back into the Vancouver zone. Conroy up the middle with a pass intended for Donovan. That didn't work. Now it's centered, bouncing in the crease, and Ault is able to reach out and cover up as the Flames throw it dangerously in front. There'll be a face-off in the Vancouver zone.
Well, what you have to be careful of, you know, Naslund had lots of get up and go, and so did Morrison on the attack. But then once the puck was turned over the other way, very lazy on the back check. And that's happened a number of times in this hockey game tonight, where they don't really bust it back as hard as they do going the other way. And because of that, Calgary's been getting chances.
Face off to the right of Ault, 7:20 to go in double overtime. And it's now 12:02 here in Calgary. Past midnight, no curfew here. As the Canucks and Flames play until somebody wins this thing. Canucks work the puck down into the Calgary zone. Regier starts from behind his own net. Robin Regier passes rink wide at center. That's picked off by Matt Cook, who dishes the puck back into his own zone for Brian Allen. Up the near side to Sammy Salo. He falls down, but is able to work the puck to Cook, who tips it deep into the Calgary end. Now moves in on the forecheck on Regier. They collide in the inboards. Naslund after the puck behind the net. Can't come up with it. Loose on the far side. Leopold sends it off the glass and out to center. Milik gave it away there. Here's Kovacu into the Vancouver zone. Making moves. Goes wide on Jovanovski. Now with a sharp angle backhander off the side of the goal. Ault gets knocked down by Oliwall in front. Play continues. Flames center of the puck. It's intercepted by Naslund. Leading a 3-on-2 the other way. Sanderson dropped pass to Naslund. Into the Calgary zone. Stops. Gets around his man. Waiting for some help. Still has the puck. Backhands it down into the corner for Sanderson. Center. Sopel shoots. Stopped by Kiprasov. Moving to his right. He stopped that one-timer off the stick of Brent Sopel. Now Sanderson from the right-wing corner. Hooks the puck to Naslund. Side of the net. Naslund, tired at the end of his shift. We're able to work the puck to Sanderson, though. Sanderson centers for Sopel. He takes the puck to the near boards. Can't do anything with it. It slides free to Kiprasov, and he'll cover up for the whistle.
What a beautiful pass from Brendan Morrison to Brent Sopel. Right on the tape, Sopel with a great chance to win it here in the second overtime as the Canucks coming up with another glorious chance. Boy, a hard-hitting hockey game, that's for sure. The bodies of both these teams are going to be very sore tomorrow, giving it everything they have.
Yell wins the face-off in his own zone. Leopold circles his net and starts out, passing ahead to Chris Clark. Clark backhands the puck in on Ault, and he's going to hang on for the whistle. So there'll be a face-off in the Vancouver zone to the right of the Canuck goaltender with 5:54 to go in double overtime.
Well, in the face-off circle, counting regulation and the first overtime session, Calgary's won 56% of the face-offs, the Canucks 44. Stefan Yell has been very busy, as is Craig Conroy. They take the majority of the face-offs. Lombardi is taking a few as well. But all three of those guys are better than 60% in the face-off circle.
Face-off to the right of Ault. Flames control. Dump the puck behind the net to Yell. Yell working on Linden, spins away from his check, comes up the near side with the puck, turns at the side of the goal. Linden tried to take it away from him. Yell gets it back, comes up the far side now, trying to hook the puck on goal. The Canucks steal it. And now Rushinsky and Chabarov skate to center 2-on-2. Rushinsky slides the puck into the near corner, goes after it there. Gets hit hard by Ferentz. Warner takes the puck, clears it off the glass and out to center. Brian Allen has it near side to Sopel. Sopel drives a long one in on Kiprusoff. Steers the puck over to Conroy. Now up to Aginla, who's able to tip it out to center ice. This is the longest overtime game in Vancouver Canucks history. Longest one before, of course, in that 1982 run in Chicago when Jim Neal scored in double overtime at 8:58 of the second overtime period. Flames almost stole the puck in the Vancouver zone. Olin now gets it, clears it off the glass, held into the line, hand pass. And Mark Crawford isn't going to like that. He thought it was a hand pass on the Zelina goal early in the third. This one they call, and the faceoff will come outside the Vancouver line.
Shots are now 49-40. And this game doesn't look like it's even close to ending yet. We might even see another overtime session.
Well, it'll be the first. It would be the first triple overtime in Canuck history, as I just mentioned. Henrik Sedin wins a faceoff outside his own line. Salo gets the puck, flips it in. And Daniel now tries to track it down deep into Calgary zone. Leopold beats into the puck, spins away from his check, and clears it out to center. Jovanovski having trouble at his own line. Niemann almost stole the puck from him, but Jovanovski was able to dive out and steer it away. He's had a couple of boo-boos here in this double overtime. Puck stays deep in the Vancouver zone. Jovanovski's back to pick it up. Ahead now to Daniel Sedin. Tip pass to center to Henrik. Tried to advance the puck. Looked like he went out of play at the Calgary bench and back on. The play continues and the Flames move up the ice. Niemann into the middle. Quick shot blocked as Ryan Allen went down to that attempt from Sean Donovan. Donovan sends the puck in deep for Niemann. A little over 4 minutes to go in a second overtime here. 4-4 the score. Sopel steals the puck and starts up with a pass to Marcus Naslund. Naslund to the Calgary line. Sopel moving up the middle towards the net. Naslund center. Sopel backhander stopped by Kiprusoff. And he covers up as Morrison tried to jar the puck loose. But Mika Kiprusoff gets the whistle with 3:59 to go in this second overtime.
And Warner gave Morrison a pretty good whack behind the net. It went undetected by the referees. Rob Schick, Mick Magoo working this game tonight.
Closing in on 100 minutes of hockey. 3:59 to go in double overtime. Chubarov on this draw to the right of Kiprusoff. And he wins it. Keane trying to find some room with the puck. Gets it to Chubarov on the left wing. He puts it to the crease. Tipped away calmly by the goaltender. Held into the line by Jovanovski. Down the right wing to Chubarov. Into the corner for Brad May. He spins away from his check. Now gets tripped up. Keeps after the puck. And it comes free to Mike Keane on the right wing. Keane spins and cycles the puck in deep again. May's after behind the net. Hit by Commodore, but bounces off the check. Feeds back to Olin. Olin at the left point. Had trouble handling the puck. Now he slides it behind the goal. Ferentz intercepts. And he's able to headman the puck to Jerome Aginla. Aginla quickly through center, over the Vancouver line. Offside, Jelena was in too soon on the left wing. .326 is what remains here in the second overtime.
You know, not a lot of line matching right now, Shorty. They're just getting fresh bodies out there, putting line combinations together, trying to find the winning combination, someone who can come up with a big goal here in overtime.
Face off outside the Vancouver line, Yell against Henrik Sedin. As the Twins come back out with Trevor Linden. Control in the neutral zone, and Chris Clark dumps the puck behind the Canuck net. Auld leaves it there for Brian Allen. Allen waiting behind the Calgary goal, leaves for Henrik Sedin. Long pass to center. Daniel tips it ahead. Linden was behind the defense, but the pass was blocked by Calgary's Robin Regier. Now it's back into Vancouver zone. Allen steers it back to Auld, over to Salo. He backhands the puck to center, gloved down by Leopold. 3 minutes to go in this second overtime. Game six. Robin Regier. Slowly through center, lead pass for Saprykin. He couldn't handle it. Linden has the puck. He gives it right back to Regier. And Regier up to Saprykin, who tips the puck in deep. Hauled out of his net, leads from Malik. He starts from behind the goal with a pass ahead to Morrison. Now up to Cook. Pass was out of his reach. Ferentz clears the puck to the line. Morrison holds it in. Behind the net for Matt Cook. Ferentz picks that off. He'll try the far side. Donovan is there, gets the puck to the line, pass Malik. Now the Flames are after it. Niemann with the Vancouver line on the right wing, checked by Sopel. Malik takes the loose puck, steers it ahead to Naslin. Here comes the captain to center. Naslin to the Calgary line, tried a right side pass for Morrison. That was blocked. Flames get the puck to the line, Naslin holds it in. Plays it in deep for Matt Cook. Cook skates to the near corner, tries to cycle behind the goal for Morrison. Marcus Nielsen picks that up, and he's able to clear the puck off the boards and out to center. Naslin at the end of his shift, can't come up with the puck. Flames dump it deep into the Vancouver zone. Sopel's back to pick it up. 2 minutes to go in double overtime. 4-4 here in Calgary. How do you go this long without scoring when they scored 8 goals in the first 60 minutes? Sopel at his own line, rink wide at center for Olin. Pass was out of his reach. Flames break back. Oliwa shoots the puck in deep. This Canuck defense pair has been up there a while. Sopel and Olin, they like to get off. Sopel gets the puck to Olin. Now up to Rushinsky at center. Now they'll make the change as Rushinsky moves in. Centers the puck. Sanderson on the right wing. Back to the line. Tomanovsky lost an edge. Loses the puck. Here's a 2-on-1 for Calgary. On the left wing, Aginla overskates the puck. Now he regains control. Centers. And Rushinsky came back to block the pass. Aginla gets the puck again in the near corner. Skates up the boards with it. Cycles it down. Brian Owl will pick that up. The ice is just so bad here in double overtime. And Aginla found that out the hard ways. He overskated that puck at a potential 2-on-1 with Oliwa. We move into the final minute now of double overtime. Brian Allen dumps the puck to center, now picks it up himself. Carries to the Calgary line, kicks the puck in. Ferentz goes back after it. Linden's got him lined up. Bodies him behind the net. Good hit by Trevor Linden. Daniel Sedin holds the puck in. Linden on the left wing, trying to make moves, loses the puck. Clark gets it to the line, held in by Malik. Now Linden down into the corner for Daniel. He's checked. Ferentz gets the puck behind his net. Fires it off the near boards and down the ice. The Canucks will take this. An offensive zone faceoff with 32.4 seconds remaining in the second overtime.
Trevor Linden's best all-around game of the series here tonight in Game 6 on the road in Calgary. Trevor comes into this game having scored 32 playoff goals in a Canucks uniform. That's second best all-time. Only the Russian Rocket, Pavel Bure, has scored more. He has 34.
Off to the left of Kiprasov. Morrison fighting for the puck off the draw, but Yell is able to draw it back to Leopold. And he starts out now with 25 seconds to go in double overtime. Leopold up the right wing. It was over two lines. As the pass was taken by Marcus Nielsen, they'll bring the faceoff back into the Calgary zone. Morrison, Cook, and Naslin stay out there. And Sallow, the defenseman. 23.4 seconds remaining in the second overtime. Morrison wins the draw. Olin with a long shoot in, gloved by Kiprasov. And Regier takes the puck, starts from behind his own net. Regier up the near side to Leopold. Now to center. Here comes Donovan into the Vancouver zone. 5 seconds to go as he was checked at the Vancouver line. Now he gets the puck back at center, sends it in deep, and time's going to run out here. 100 minutes of hockey complete in Game 6, and still no winner. As some pushing on the whistle involving Brendan Morrison and Marcus Nielsen, Cook comes in to give Nielsen a shot. They're tired, but they've still got some grit to their game, both these teams. 4-4 through double overtime. As we wait to see whether the Canucks season will continue or whether Calgary tonight will move on to the second round.
Shots on goal in the second overtime session by Vancouver, 7 for a game total now of 50. For Calgary, 6 for a game total now of 40.